This video is sponsored by Audible. Go to audible.com/polyphonic or text polyphonic to 500-500 to get 3 months for just $6.95 a month. Music has always had close ties to literature. Songwriters are quick to reference poetry in their lyrics or draw inspiration from works of fiction. And although many authors get nods, there was one in particular who became a favorite of 70s rock scenes, J.R.R. Tolkien. And so, long before his books were made into the feature films you know and love, some of your favorite musicians were trying their hand at putting Tolkien into their art. Let's take a closer look at who some of these artists are, and just why we love referencing Tolkien so much. If we're gonna have a conversation about Tolkien and music, there's really only one place to start: Led Zeppelin. Their earliest Tolkien references can be found in 1968's Ramble On. Leaves are falling all around. Time I was on my way. That song uses the stories of perilous journeys that drive The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings to parallel Zeppelin's own adventures touring. Some have even taken the song's opening lines as a paraphrasing of Numaire, a poem that Tolkien wrote. The opening lines of that poem translate to, "Like gold fall the leaves in the wind." In Ramble On's third verse, we get the most overt references to Lord of the Rings, where Robert Plant name drops both Gollum and Mordor. In the darkest depths of Mordor, my metaphor. And this wasn't the only song where Zeppelin compared searching for love on the road to the quest for the One Ring. 1973's Over the Hills and Far Away is a reference to another Tolkien poem, Over Old Hills and Far Away. In that song, Robert Plant sings of an epic journey questing after love. In an interview with The Independent, Robert Plant talked about how important Tolkien and Lord of the Rings were to him. He said, "When I read the books, they kind of dissolved into me." Plant loved the book so much that he named his pet dog Strider after a character in Lord of the Rings. And Zeppelin's fourth album carried two more clear references to Middle-earth. Misty Mountain Hop references a mountain range in Tolkien's world, while Battle of Evermore name drops the Ringwraith amongst lyrics of an epic struggle full of fantastical figures. While Zeppelin had a deep love for Tolkien, many of their peers enjoyed his work as well. On their 1970 debut album, Black Sabbath featured a song called The Wizard. Its lyrics sing of a powerful wizard who brings joy in his wake and casts away dark forces. In a 2005 interview, bassist Geezer Butler said he was reading Lord of the Rings when Sabbath were writing this song, and he based it partially on Gandalf. That same year, progressive rockers Genesis released their second studio album. Their music was steeped in fantasy, and while there weren't any overt Tolkien references, that album features a song called Stagnation. In that song, there's an interlude with lyrics that sound like a familiar character for anyone who knows their Tolkien. And will I wait forever? Beside the silent mirror, and fish for bitter minnows amongst the weeds. Progressive rock was a perfect place for Tolkien references, given the epic nature of the subgenre. You can see that on Camel's 1974 album Mirage. That album featured a track called Nimrodel/The Procession/The White Rider. Nimrodel is the name of an elvish maid from Lothlorien, featured in Lord of the Rings. In addition to the title, the song's third section is clearly about the wizard Gandalf. It sings of how he once wore gray and came back in white. The wizard of them all came back from his fall, this time wearing white. For more evidence of Tolkien's influence on prog rock, you can look at band names. Mirkwood and Marillion both took their names from Tolkien's work. Rush also referenced Tolkien in their early work. The 1975 album Fly By Night featured a song called Rivendell, depicting the beautiful elven city in Middle-earth. And on their next album, Rush delved deeper into Tolkien's mythology, with Neil Peart writing The Necromancer. The Dark Lord Sauron is referred to by that title in The Hobbit, and this song seems to draw on the darkness of Tolkien's villain. Rooting in the groundwork laid by these acts in the 70s, Tolkien references would continue to grow throughout music in the decades to come. Many metal bands have named themselves after the Tolkien mythos, and Middle-earth references are commonplace in metal lyrics to this day. So, what is it about Tolkien that inspired so much writing? I think you can point to a few things. First, I think Tolkien's imagery has always been musical. His stories are laden with songs, and music plays an integral role in the very founding of Middle-earth. When we read these stories, we like to imagine how the music ties to them and create our own interpretation of that music. Even Tolkien's descriptions of his location seem to transcend just appearance. We want to find new ways to experience these fantastical realms, things to bring us closer to this beautiful reality. And that's what songs like Rivendell are great for, helping detach us from Earth and transport us deeper into this world that Tolkien created. It's not just places though. Tolkien used archetypal figures, figures that draw on long histories of mythology and storytelling. Because of this, these figures tap into something human in all of us, and that's something people love to explore. A character like Gandalf inspires so many songs because he reminds us of other magical beings in history and of the people that protect and inspire us in our own lives. And the same can be said for Tolkien's journey. As we saw with Zeppelin, musicians are frequently on the road, on a journey, or a quest. And to some extent, we're all on our own adventures. And I think that's why we love Tolkien, and why we love music that draws on him. It helps us feel a part of something bigger, and helps us build a soundtrack to our own personal quests. So I'm a big fan of Tolkien, and it goes beyond just Lord of the Rings. One of my personal favorite stories of his is The Children of Húrin. That's an epic story filled with Tolkien's archetypal struggles of good and evil, tragedy and adventure. If you want to check it out, I recommend Audible. Audible is the best place online to find audiobooks. When I read The Children of Húrin, I listened to the audiobook, and it was amazing not only for the prose, but because it was narrated by the late great Christopher Lee. Lee was of course a good friend of Tolkien and played Saruman in the Lord of the Rings movie, so he really knew and respected the source material. I love Audible because it means you can read these great works when you're on the go, in transit, or just doing some chores at home. So go to audible.com/polyphonic or text polyphonic to 500-500 and you'll get 3 months for just $6.95 a month. Each month gives you 3 free titles, 1 free audiobook, and 2 Audible originals. So please go check it out and remember to use my code or follow the link in the description and you'll get a great deal and you'll show them that I sent you and support my channel.